Bill Caswell, where's my manners?
I know you, Linda. Mike never stopped talking about you morning, noon, and night. You are the swellest dame on earth. Will you marry me, Linda?
To this year's starting right fielder for the Cleveland Indians.
Well, I'll be happy if I make the farm team.
Why do you have to go to Florida?
You can't play ball up here in the winter.
Well, why don't you wait till the weather gets warmer and they come and play here?
When a young man is away on his own, temptations may arise.
I won't eat my vegetables.
You know full well what I'm saying. There are a certain type of women that make things difficult for a man when he's away from his family, or should I say too easy, especially if he's single.
I want to get married, and I want you to come with me.
I can't come with you. I can't give up my shot at being a radio star.
Well, what are we going to do?
They're gonna get very lucky. You're gonna fall down on your way to first from the weight of all that stuff.
Welcome to the first Cleveland Indians intra-squad game of 1946.
A new Lucky Charm, Metcalf.
How did it go today, honey? Everybody here is dying to know.
How'd you do, Slugger?
Did you get a hit? Are you still there, Jeff? Tell us what happened.
Sorry, Mom, I can't hear you.
I said, tell us...
Well, it must be a bad connection. I'll talk to
you later. Bye.
Bad connection.
You got to accent. You ate the positive, eliminate the negative, and latch on to be affirmative. Don't mess with this between. You gotta spread joy up to the maximum. Bring gloom down to the minimum. Have faith or pandemonium liable to walk upon the scene. To illustrate my last remark,
Jonah in the whale, Noah in the ark.
What did they do just when everything looked so dark? Man, they said you got to accept,
you ain't the positive evil, mine ain't the negative, and latch on to the affirmative.
Don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between. No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
No, don't mess with Mr. In Between.
Long distance operator, please.
State, please.
Ohio?
In the city.
River Run?
Pardon?
River Run.
Calling to see if you can get your old job back?
Calling my fiance.
Word to the wise, Buckeye. If she's only a fiance, there's still plenty of time to skedaddle.
Blackburn 530? I don't want to skedaddle, and Ginger's as sweet as they come. If I have a bad day, it's not so bad after I talk to her.
Bad day? After this week, I'd say your little dame's got to work it out for her.
Will you excuse me? This conversation's private.
WREQ, voice of Greater River Run.
Hey, it's me.
Jeff, hi. Oh, hold on one second.
WREQ, voice of Greater River Run.
Would you play till the end of time?
I'll pass on your request. Hi again.
Hi. Ginger,
oh, hold on one second.
WREQ, voice of Greater River Run.
Yeah, who would I speak to about?
Little lady likes to talk a lot, does she? Can't get a word in edgewise.
I'm back. How'd it go today?
Not so great.
What's the matter?
Well, I haven't had it.
Hang on.
Ginger, the announcer's losing his cookies in the bathroom. Get in the studio and cover.
Do what?
Cover. All you have to do is read.
What about the phones?
This is more important.
Jeff, I've got to read. I'll call you later. Bye.
Ginger. Goodbye, honey. I love you, too.
Some swell dame. Made you feel like $1 million, right, Buckeye?
As a matter of fact, she did. Why don't you call your parole officer?
What do you have?
A beer, please.
This one's on the house.
Thanks.
After a week like you've had, you need something nice to happen to you, Jeff.
You know my name?
Medcalf. Right field. 0-for-8 this week.
We read every day about the inability of employers and employees to get together and discuss their differences with civility. But I see no reason on earth why we can't sit across from one another, talk like civilized people until we come to a meeting of the minds. We are, after all, reasonable men, and we have a great deal in common. Not the least of which is a mutual interest in the profitable operation of this factory. I understand you have prepared a set of contract proposals.
We have. This is a summary.
Paid sick leave? You want me to pay people to lie at home in bed?
Does your income stop when you and Miss Sloan get sick?
A 20% raise? Is this a typing error?
No.
We can't afford a 20% wage increase.
Prove it.
I beg pardon?
Show us your books.
Get out of my office.
The forecast is for colder weather with a low tonight in the upper 20s and a high tomorrow of 33 degrees. The temperature will drop again as light rain turns to snow flurries by evening. So bundle up and remember that at Miller's, no matter how cold it is outside, the welcome is always warm inside. The 9 o'clock weather report is brought to you by Miller's Hardware, where you'll always find fair prices and friendly service. This is WREQ, the voice of Greater River Run, the station that plays your favorites.
That's Ginger. It's Ginger. I'd swear I'd recognize her voice anywhere. Is she swell?
She was aces.
Oh.
Hey, watch it, second clutch in. That's it? It doesn't seem that cold tonight, though.
Who cares? I wonder about... Wait.
A special request going out to Linda and Bill.
Oh, no. Oh, I'm gonna kill her.
Oh, you're gonna kill us both? Watch it. Clutch, clutch.
That is her idea of a joke.
I'll handle the radio. You handle the wheel. And how do you know I didn't request that song?
Did you?
No. But I should have. Pull over. Let's go through this again. Okay. Neutral is in the middle of the small letter H. No, remember?
Never move the gear shift without putting the clutch in. That's it. Backward small letter H, first.
Yes. Second. Yes. Third. I don't know about that forecast. I find it very warm in here. But maybe it's not the weather.
Hey!
Yes?
Good evening, Mrs. Sloan.
Is Jean in?
Yes.
We've come to visit.
May we see her?
No, I'm afraid that's not possible. Good night.
She's not feeling
well?
She's
asleep already.
You can't see her because I don't want you in my house.
Oh, Mr. Sloan, there's no hard feelings.
You're mistaken. There are hard feelings. It's taken us years to build our company, and we don't look fondly on the prospect of having it destroyed by a bunch of greedy ingrates.
Hey, you lousy...
It won't do any good. It'll upset Gina. We'll phone her tomorrow.
He calls that civility? You call that civility?
So exciting to hear your voice. I know somebody famous.
Tell the truth. How'd I do?
You were swell.
Although you shouldn't have played that song.
You sounded very professional to me, and I like the song.
Thanks. Oh, I've got to go. That might be Jeff, and I've been trying to get a hold of him for the past half hour. Bye. WREQ, voice...
This is Ginger's
Able. Yes, it is.
Was that you reading the weather?
Yes.
I am 33. It's 50 out there. You just read last week's weather. Do anything that stupid again, you're fired.
Yes, sir. Last week's weather?
I wasn't going to tell you.
You weren't going to tell me I read an old forecast?
You sounded very professional.
Tonight's forecast is for unseasonably warm temperatures.
But your reading was terrific.
I'm never showing my face in public again for the rest of my life. Please excuse me.
The picture up against tomorrow has a little quirk you can spot. He dips his left shoulder just before he throws a fastball.
Every time?
Every time I've seen him.
How did you learn so much about baseball?
It comes with the territory, I guess. If I lived in Montreal, I'd know hockey.
Hey, see you later. I'm glad you live here, because I'm grateful for the advice. I'm grateful for the beer.
Anytime, Jeff. See you tomorrow.
See ya.
That little Buckeye is adorable.
He's engaged.
Good. That means he's not married.
Off in today's intra-squad game and playing right field, number 9, Jeff Metcalf.
Going home by way of Lexington, Cincinnati, or Indianapolis to Columbus, because I got some stuff you can bring my wife if you're passing through Cincy.
I'm not going home, Jay.
Ginger! It's me.
Hi, how's it going?
Fine, how's everything going with you?
Fine. Not really.
What's the matter?
I got my big break and I blew it.
What happened?
I read on air with the wrong copy.
What does that mean?
I read a week-old weather report over the radio.
Well, the weather up there is always wet and cold anyway, so maybe nobody noticed.
The station manager noticed.
I'm sorry about that. Look, I've got a bigger problem.
Oh, no, you said you were fine.
I was too embarrassed to tell you.
Tell me what?
I haven't had a hit yet.
Why is that? Hang on.
My advice is you don't get any more of your clothes dirty. That way you won't have to do your laundry again before you head home. First cut's on Friday.
Why is that a bigger problem than mine?
This is my shot at the big leagues.
This is my shot at acting.
Ginger, there must be 1,000 radio stations across the country. There's only one National League and one American League.
Is that so?
Well, you'd know that if you ever read the sports page.
What?
Nothing.
Well, I'm sorry I bothered you with my petty little problem.
I didn't say it was petty.
Well, you said your problem was bigger than mine.
Well, it is.
Hang on.
Aren't you worried about keeping her out?
No, the air is good for her. It's warm.
Somebody said they heard on the radio there's another cold front coming.
Eventually, when the cold comes, we go back home, but not now. This is Emma's first time out for a walk.
It is? I can say I took Emma on her first walk. Here, I'll buy her first Valentine, too, and one for you. And speaking about coming home, you've got to move back to the flat.
It would break my father-in-law's heart.
Well, I'll break his heart.
Charlie, Emma not be alive if not for his money. What if she gets sick again?
Well, let him pay for the doctor bills again. It doesn't mean that you have to live with them. Gina, he wouldn't let Caroline and me visit you.
You know what?
He no let us in the house.
Why?
He's all hot and bothered about the contract negotiations. But even if he weren't, you've got to get out of there. You don't want little Emma to grow up and be like Big Ruth.
It's not kind to say.
But it's true to say. Gina, what happens when it rains or it's too cold and you have to stay inside? Does that mean that I can't come visit you and Emma?
If you no let my friends come to visit, then I must to live in other place.
What are you talking about?
My friends come to visit me and you no let them in.
Who no let them? Who didn't let them in?
Gina, I have been as civil as possible to these people, to Charlie Haley, not to mention Gloria's son, Robert. But these same people are trying to put us out of business. We are talking about Emma's future.
I am not, in the making deal. I'm sorry you don't like my friends, but either they come or I go away.
Naturally, they may visit.
Thank you. Good night.
Good night.
Good night, nurse. It's not bad enough we have to deal with these people at the plant. We have them in our home.
It's a small price to pay to keep our granddaughter here. You know perfectly well that if Gina were to leave this house, I wouldn't sleep nights for fear she'd enroll the baby in Hebrew school or God knows what. Now I want a martini. I wasn't going to have one tonight, but now you've made me want one.
Seems to me like we keep meeting in the middle of the night. Think it's fate?
I think you're an insomniac. I think I'm out of my mind to try and finish your laundry before you leave.
You got that stain out of my shirt. There's nothing you can't do, is there?
Here, I'll carry this.
Make a mean batch of scrambled eggs? I know, I'm a connoisseur. And I remember. I know you thought that I was too hungover to notice, but I wasn't, only pretended.
Oh, why?
Why, indeed. Face to face with the most perfect woman on earth, any guy would lose his nerve. A woman so beautiful who can do anything.
Oh, please.
You got a head on your shoulders. You should run the union. Heck, you should run the company. It'd take a heck of a lot of courage, and I don't mean the kind out of a bottle, to ask the most perfect woman on earth the time of day. A guy wouldn't want to get egg on his face. Even great scrambled egg. Good night.
Good night.
Heading home?
In a minute.
We could catch the midnight show.
No, thanks.
You want me to walk you home?
No, thanks.
You have, I have a lot of experience with the microphone. I could teach you.
Rehearse with me.
Show you what I know, how to use it. I mean, now, if you want it.
Maybe tomorrow I'm, expecting a call.
Ginger, it's late. Jeff might not call.
W-R-E-Q.
Ginger, it's me.
Hi. Good night, Paul.
Good night.
I'm sorry we argued, and I'm sorry I said your problem wasn't as big as mine.
It's okay.
It's just that I haven't had a hit since I've been here.
Why not?
Well, if I knew that, I'd be hitting, wouldn't I?
Well, I mean, I just thought maybe they weren't letting you take your turn. I thought that's what you meant. Are you catching?
I play right field.
Don't you catch the balls they throw out there?
I thought you meant was high catcher, which is a different position. Yes, I've been catching. I haven't had any errors.
Well, that's something. That's a big part of what they judge you on, isn't it? You do the catching and the running and the throwing all right, don't you? So all you have to do is work on the hitting part.
This isn't a dance contest.
I didn't say it was. Why are you so angry at me?
I'm not.
What? You could have fooled me.
I'm glad I called. Goodbye.
Closing time.
Oh, okay, thanks.
Thanks. You do that like you've done it before.
It's my real job, and I better stay in practice because I'm not gonna make the first cut.
Don't jinx yourself.
It's too late for that.
Can I give you some advice?
Quit before they cut me?
Empty your pockets.
What?
And your shoe. You're the kind who put a lucky penny in his shoe.
Shows how much you know. It's a lucky nickel. It's a buffalo.
You keep something stuck in your calf, too, don't you? Leave all those good luck charms in your locker. They don't do you a hill of beans.
Well, what am I supposed to fall back on? And don't say prayer.
You've got nothing but yourself. When you get up to the plate, erase the crowd, erase your teammates, erase your fiancé. Pretend you're all alone. Pretend there's no one in the ballpark but you. Try it.
do any worse than I've been doing.
Now, maybe you'll get lucky.
He's sick again. Come on.
They're gonna give me another chance?
You've got no choice. Now, remember, the microphone is not a human ear, okay? You're talking to people by way of a lot of wires and transmitters and receivers. Neighbors' dogs are barking, kids are fighting. So you've got to enunciate and project.
Another chance. Another chance.
If you've been here 3 hours straight, then you can sit. Otherwise, it's the best way to get the most out of what you got. Okay, Kaiser never sits. Read.
Batting six, number nine, Jeff as if you're married to him, but still like him.
Beat it, kid. I'm not that sick. The phones are ringing like mad. This is WREQ.
If he doesn't let me in, I deck him.
Don't start a fight. Mr. Haley, welcome.
Hi, Charlie. Caroline, come on in.
Please.
Hold it. What was that for?
Call it a memento. We'll send you a copy.
Would you like a drink before you go up?
No, thanks.
Well, maybe afterwards, then.
Thank you.
I see your father-in-law had quite a change of heart.
I think you would be in the newspaper soon.
I should have known that son of a...
Charlie, what in front of the baby? What harm can it do?
Pretending they're something they ain't. That's what the harm is.
You would watch the baby while I get more bottle?
You stay. I'll get it.
Caroline, your new hair is pretty.
Oh, thanks, love.
I want to ask you something. I shouldn't ask, but I have to ask before it's too late. And I hope you don't... Have you picked a godfather yet for her?
No, Charlie.
Good. Because I promise, I swear, I would be the best godfather I ever could have. And I would take it very seriously. And I'd be privileged. I know I shouldn't just jump in and ask like that, but what the hell? Part of my French. And I promise I won't talk like that in front of her when she's old enough to understand.
Charlie, I'm sorry.
You had her baptized already?
No baptize.
Well, good.
No baptize. I am Jewish.
Go on, you're Italian.
And Jewish.
Did Mike know?
Yes.
Do the in-laws know?
Yes.
Oh, they must have loved that. Does Caroline know?
Yes.
Well, you tell Caroline, you don't tell me?
Charlie, you sometimes say things about the Jews, and I think you don't like us very much.
What are you talking about? What did I say? Maybe I said that they were smart. But hell, heck, that's a compliment. I mean, how could you think that I wouldn't like you because you were Jewish? How could you think that, Gina? And little Emma, I love little Emma. I couldn't care less that she were half Jewish. I wouldn't love her any less if she were all Jewish.
Gina needed more formula. Your granddaughter has quite an appetite.
Would you like some help?
Oh, thanks. It's no trouble.
Then if I'm not in the way, I'll just make myself a cup of tea.
Certainly. You deserve a cuppa. A little peace and quiet. I don't know how you manage. Running the business with your husband and running the household, too?
Well, we do what we have to do.
Mrs. Sloan, I don't want to be too forward, but I do want to say that I'm sorry about this union business and assure you that my husband has a heart of gold. He would never do anything, anything irresponsible.
Would that you could guarantee that.
Oh, I do guarantee it. I love him, but we don't see eye to eye on everything.
Nor should you, necessarily.
And we're certainly not in agreement on this union business.
Best marriages allow for differences of opinion.
I agree.
You've done something to your hair.
This is my natural color.
It's lovely.
When you told me you almost died, and the Germans almost killed you, you were in a concentration camp?
Auschwitz.
Oh, no, Gina, I'm so sorry. You must think I'm pretty dense. Not putting two and two together.
No.
I'm sorry about the baptism stuff. I didn't mean to offend you.
It's no offending. What is godparents' job?
When you agree to be a godparent, you take it very seriously because you're supposed to sort of be a guardian angel here on Earth for the baby. If anything happens to its parents.
You would take care of Emma if I die?
Don't talk like that.
No, but this is what godparent means to you.
I'd keep an eye on her, 100% guaranteed.
My baby needs an uncle.
How did you come out so sweet?
What is his question?
I mean to say, if I had been through what you'd have been through, if I had survived a Nazi concentration camp and lost all my family,
I would spend the rest of my life killing Germans. I'd spend the rest of my life getting revenge.
What means revenge?
It means paying them back, getting them back for what they did to me. Tit for tat, eye for an eye.
Vendetta.
Vendetta, right. So your English is getting better every day. But you're so gentle. You're not angry.
I am angry. And I never forget what happened. But I am have revenge every day by staying alive. To be alive is my revenge. And to be happy is my revenge. And to raise Emma so she be happy, this is also my revenge. Nazis not win. Nazis not win.
I'm as interested in safety as the next man, but this isn't a playground.
Excuse me, Sam.
Yes, sir.
You remember Mrs. Haley, Charlie Haley's wife?
Indeed I do. Good afternoon, Mrs. Haley.
Good afternoon.
Mrs. Haley is applying for a job, and I'd like her to have the opening in the filing office.
There's no opening.
Just show up bright and early Monday morning, and Sam will take care of all the paperwork and introduce you to your co-workers.
I'm terribly grateful, Mr. Sloan.
Not at all. Till Monday, then.
Till Monday. Good day.
Good day.
Good day.
With all due respect, sir, do we need another radical unionist on the payroll?
I have it on good authority. She's not one bit radical.
The NLRB says we have to give them a reasonable time to respond.
We will be more than reasonable, Sam. Time is on our side. Here is our last and final counteroffer.
I'm very excited to be working at the factory.
And we're excited about you being there, Mrs. Haley. We value employees who value their jobs. We feel a sense of obligation to them. That sense of obligation is what makes us fear the prospect of a strike.
Oh, I don't think it'll come to that. Do you?
Well, I hope not. And we'll do everything in our power to avoid one. But who knows what miscalculations might be made? We can account for our actions, but we can't account for irresponsibility on the other side.
I think that they're very responsible people. I know my husband...
I'm talking about judgments based on misinformation. Being informed is the only way to avoid a mistake. Information is the key to avoiding calamity. My husband and I have made it our policy to reward loyalty and initiative. We've had a bonus program for quite some time. Did you know that?
No.
We don't publicize it for fear of making non-participants jealous.
Now, don't be so down in the mouth. Oh, why? Just because I got my one chance and I blew it and I'm never going to get another chance?
Don't talk like Grand that. Letters. They're going to give you another chance.
Another chance answering phones.
Yes, I'll
drown your sorrows in a double phosphate. My treat.
It's Jeff.
Mom?
I made the first cut.
Oh, I'm so proud of you.
Look, tell Hank and Linda, will you?
Of course I will, honey. Congratulations.
Thank you. I've got to call Ginger.
She's right here.
I had some news.
You made it?
I made the cut.
Jeff made the team.
No, I made the cut.
What's that?
That means I'm still on roster.
Well, I said congratulations.
No, I didn't make the team. I just wasn't cut from the team.
You weren't cut from the team yesterday or the day before. In fact, you haven't been cut so far, so why is not getting cut today such big news? This is a little bit like Alice in Wonderland's on birthday.
Ginger, I don't think you try to understand baseball.
I don't what?
You don't try.
I try a lot harder than you try to understand my profession.
What's a potentiometer?
What's a ribbon mic? What's a boom? What's a dB? What's a whole lot of dBs?
How should I know?
And that's how much you try to understand my profession.
Congratulations on not being dropped off your team.
Well, thank you. And congratulations for not getting fired from your job.
Thank you. I've got to get to the station now. Bye.
I lock up in a half hour.
Oh, I've had more than enough beer for a guy in spring training anyway.
I said I had to lock up. I didn't necessarily mean lock up after you're gone.
Hi. In case I don't see you in the morning, thanks for everything.
What time are you leaving?
I want to get an early start.
Thanks for the driving lessons.
My pleasure.
I can't imagine that's true.
It is true, Linda.
Well,
what else is true is it's late. I'm leaving, so I've got nothing to lose if I speak my piece. You gotta understand, a guy doesn't... No matter how much he admires a woman, a guy doesn't come on to his buddy's girlfriend. And even though his buddy's dead, he still feels funny about it. And I was thinking maybe you thought I didn't like or admire you, but nothing could be further from the truth. I figured you were feeling like a widow, and I didn't want to take advantage, so to speak. But don't think for a minute. Well, maybe under different circumstances. Who knows?
Well, maybe we could start over. As if it were different circumstances.
Maybe I should call my mother and tell her I won't be home right away.
Can I walk you home?
No, thanks.
When are you going to say yes?
Paul, under different circumstances, maybe. I'm engaged.
And your fiancé is 1,000 miles away.
And still my fiancé.
Do you know what goes on in those baseball camps? These professional players have women waiting for them after every game, before every game, between innings, when they go home at night.
That is pretty mean and selfish.
I just didn't want you to be disappointed if anything happens that you didn't want to happen.
I'm not worried.
You should be.
You don't know Jeff.
If he breaks your heart, will you let me walk you home?
You don't know him. He's not going to break my heart.
I hope you're right. Because you're too sweet to marry a guy who would two-time you.
Good night.
You locking me in?
You can let yourself out.
Thanks for the hospitality.
You know, it's cooler up in my apartment. I live right out back. Upstairs. I don't kiss and tell, if that's what you're worried about. And then I run away, I'll come back some other day. Oh, you fool, that was love, says my heart. They have no strike fund to help the members survive a strike.
They have no strike fund. Oh my God, a lockout.
I got kids to feed.
Talk to your union buddies. They're responsible.
I'll make you happy no matter where we live.
Bill, I'm in no mood for jokes.
I'm not joking, Linda. I want you to marry me.
Jeff?
What are you doing here?
I'm Ted Koppel. Later on Nightline, it's come down to the oil industry versus the baby seals, the growing movement which says it's the environmentalists who are wrecking the country.
Tomorrow, it's the ultimate challenge for Doogie. Vinny wants him to see what it's like to be an average American teenager and gets him a job in a fast food restaurant on Doogie Howser, M.D. Then it's a shocking new Anything But Love. Tomorrow.